It was just a regular day in the mid-19th century that a son was finally born to the wife of Marvin Stratton. A shipbuilder by trade, church-going and successful. I will teach him side by side and hand to hand to be a man. He will live his life as if gold ran through his veins. We gave him life, so we gave him the name Winfield Scott Stratton. So he cussed out his old man and he left for the promised land of Colorado. Built castles for the queens and the nobility. Studied the science of mines and geology. Gambled away most of his pay. His veins. He was a nobody now, but he was out looking for fame. Winfield Scott Stratton. On a beautiful Cripple Creek day, Winfield was out working his claim. When his axe pick hit in such a way that would forever alter his life and his name. He called his mind the Independence. That was the one thing he would never deliver. Still the country had another king. No one It was a fact now, gold ran through his veins. He was a rich man now, but everyone knew the name Winfield Scott Stratton. Soon he gave his gold mine away. $10 million, it's still mine today. And went out and bought the biggest house he could find in Colorado. He dragged a hide from haunted clarity. Fortune collided with a curse. The cureless ailment of a tortured soul. Fortune and fame. It said some folks try to steal the gold from your veins. Either unknown, notorious, it's really not the same. Winfield Scott Stratton. just in time. So he set out to ease the plight of the working poor and their families. People down on their luck came to his door. He built a home for the widowed and the orphaned that still serves us today. Built in the memory of his father, Myron Stratton. And to this day, people say gold ran through his veins. He's not lost, he's just one and the same. Winfield Scott Stratton.